July 31st, 1968, my mama said a tree had fell on the crib the same day. Actually, it was my father, that's what he said when he called. He wasn't inside the room when I was born. My big brother was just about to be 2 in like 30 days or less. We had to move to an apartment, that tree had made a mess. My daddy worked at Bethlehem Steel, my mama who he paid for gas. And we ain't had much at all, but they maintained that we blessed. They was both from Jefferson Street, about a block away from the hospital. The Al Capone died, and when my daddy was about to be 2, his mama was an immigrant. She died when he was just a child, his daddy died when he was 15. And that was around the time he's moving to the county in the neighborhood called Hawthorne, made a brick like in the city. But you're gonna need a lawnmower, cause we in the sticks, and that's how it was looking long before I was born. And for those from out of town, I live in Baltimore, so everybody either sniffing heroin or smoking marijuana. There's two sides to every corner, but you gotta touch either side just to get to the other side of the other. So by the time I was walking in Kenwood, me and my brother was disappointing my mother and showing up at the door in some handcuffs and hoping that she still loves us. In my defense, it took me a while to fuck with the other shit. 18, I start seeing rides, but I never fuck with it. My brother did. Sold us some blow to an undercover. What our daddy beat us with, where our troubles is. Felt like we was nothing. We really not doing nothing. So it's nothing you can tell us while we try and figure how to live. I dropped out in the 10th grade. Moved to Ocean City with my mama. Got a job at Fenwick Inn while I was selling marijuana. Not a K. I'm 17. I never told y'all I could sing. But I be sounding like a Jackson. But I'm just as white as Dr. King statue in D.C. But that's where I be singing at. And that's where a man selling dreams was just happening to be. But even then it seems that I didn't believe. I expect to see progress and some shit I never seen. Paying my papa checks cause we got a lot of stress on top of heads. I just collect my weed and smoke a lot of it and pocket every dollar I be profiting. And after a while I move back around the way and say no was the phrase that they coined. But not a lot has changed as time passed. The chemical imbalances inside my brain became a lot to carry. So I medicate to hide the pain. I'm distancing so far I don't understand what my mama's saying. To keep my spirit high, I kept my cousins round and tried cocaine in 95. Met a girl named Debbie, we got married in 96. Had a son in 97, swore he'd never be like this. Debbie was from California and her daddy was a vet. He got hit and got the purple heart. I'm at war with myself. I had a job cutting grass for BG&E. My lady had a job at a bank and she had a degree. I'm good long as my family's safe. And I knew I could eat the pain the day I fell off a tractor and it cut off my feet. It turns out I'm a brilliant actor, away through surgery. While we had our back turned, they stole my lady purse that day. And they gave me my purse that day in May of 03. And now I'm laid up in a wheelchair with no places to be. But then someday I started walking again. That's when I told my son the pain is a sensation and mentally we can overcome. And then he broke his leg in 2 years. And the rhetoric was he never walk again, but he did. So now they call him luck, his grade slipped, but he persevered. He was smarter than me, they told my mama I was retarded. So that's what I believed, I passed my GED with a D. But luck of A's and B's, the qualities they seeing in him, they didn't see in me, I'm happy with it. But he'd do anything if his daddy did it. I just told him don't be like me, cause he can be better than it. Started slipping after that happened. And then my daddy got cancer, that was August 06. He died in March of 07, I slipped and fell and spent a night sitting in jail. I told Lucky I had a problem, I had to get taken care of. Went to rehab somewhere out the Eastern Shore. Figured it wasn't for me, I called a hack back to Essex and showed up at my mama's door like I'ma fix it myself. But I got laid off every year when it got colder and that shit didn't help. And my relationship was shorty, getting fucked up as can be. I started to notice that these drugs is destroying my family, how they does. And Luck was turning 16, his man's called Charles for murder, but he stayed out the streets because Luck be spitting bars. They said that's how this country built to be and he knew what it was. I said he don't know shit and dismissed it because I didn't understand until years later. I drove my truck down in my mama crib at the bottom of Florida because I put my hands on his mama. She forced me to leave after she called the police. But now my son is 18 and I don't know what to believe, because how the fuck is these drugs getting to me? I had to come to my senses and take responsibility, because I just stole a bunch of bread to get down to my mama crib. But my baby boy is a man and they know everywhere he be. I had to tell him lay low until I get back on my feet. I came back in 2 weeks, put it back where it's supposed to be. But now this job is not enough, so I'm falling back on the weed that I'm growing out of the crib, and the pills are prescribed to me. But y'all know the saying, never get high on your own supply. Now my cousins live with me and the youngest is 45 and we was junkies, got evicted and my son was 21. It's 2018, I'm living in a tent deep in the woods, and I just lost a stepson to the same drugs that I'm sniffing up. But Luck exhibits so much potential, so I just pray for one day that he can lift me up. But he still gotta pick me up to go to my appointments so I could get my insurance, cause this money gotta get me some. Lawyers moving slow in 2020, I got kicked out of shelter, nowhere to go. I had to head back to my mama and I said goodbye to Luck. That was the third and last time he ever saw me standing up. And then in 4 months, it was June, I called Luck to wake him up and tell him I was was in the hospital and don't know what to do. But I don't think he understood because I wasn't making sense. I was slurring my words because my kidney and liver went. That night I died and got resuscitated. I was in the hospital in Miami where they say the gangsters go to die. So right now I got my mother going crazy. And my son is knowing everything my brother told my old lady about. But now we talking every day, me and love. He even came to see me. He was there to comfort my mother. But Lucky named him Mimi and he got to show me his lady and she was beautiful. I said, you doing good for yourself, boy. If only you knew. My clock ticking relentlessly and the last time he saw me standing up, the doctor said it was the end for me. Insurance wouldn't cover me and life wasn't enough for me to live inside a hospital while I was hooked up to machines. And I ain't talked to God in a while. But now my son is saying that we don't really die when we die. We go to another place. I promise this is not the end when I'm not here physically. I hope I'm an example because it's what withdrawal did to me. I spent my life running from feelings I couldn't swerve. My lady looked at me crazy. She didn't want me. And hers, July 6th, my son picked up his girl after he cried. And that's because that was the day that I died. I can confirm it really ain't no drugs in heaven. And I'm better than I was before. Don't feel the need to do them because nobody up here hurt no more. And regardless of the fact I had no money when I died, I'm the reason Lil Lucky, the best rapper alive. Fuck is you talking about? Whoa. Keep it going, bro. Shit, you a legend, bro. Let's go. Whoa, whoa.